here tonight with another interview for the Battle of the Bands, right? For the Northern
Fucking
Invasion
right.
Tour.
Yeah.
And we are here with
Ashes from Stone.
Right? Ashes from the, you're the first ones to go on, the first ones to show what you got, right?
Yep.
All right, so I'm going to step on and hold the camera while we do the interview.
Sure thing.
So you know what the project is about, or somebody, I know we've been talking, right?
A little bit, yep.
A little bit about what it is. Do you realize, though, that you're helping to raise over 1 million meals this year for kids? That is our goal this year, 1 million meals.
That's good,
so yes.
You are a part of that, in with some names like Drowning Pool, Pop Evil, Skillet Hinder, your interviews and going with all of those. And
awesome.
Everybody
yes.
Awesome.
So knowing what the project is about, you know, what was it about that you decided to say, yes, you know, we need to do this? Because you could have very easily just said, you know, we don't have time, but...
Well, you know, I've done things like this before. Like I've served at Feed My Starving Children a few times with my church group, and you know, it's just such a rewarding experience to know like what you're doing for people there. Like you stand there for a couple hours, they give you kind of a tutorial and what you're going to be doing, you know, different stations at the place, and it's just like just the amount of meals that you make at the end of the day. Like they tell you like how many people you've served, and you sit there at the end of the day and you're like, holy crap, we did that in like an hour. Like it doesn't take much, and it's so rewarding. Like we take for granted a lot of the stuff that we do and we have, and just to commit some of your time like that is such a cool experience.
Mm-hmm.
For you guys, if you guys haven't done that, definitely go and do Feed My Starving Children. It's
yeah,
really
that's
cool.
Yeah, good thing to do, right? Thank you very much. So this kind of you probably understand more because you did the whole Feed My Starving Children.
Mm-hmm.
Do you realize that right now the statistics in the U.S. are that 1 in 5 kids are the ones who are facing severe food insecurity, actual true hunger in the U.S. 1 in 5. So that's at least.
I didn't know that. No.
I didn't know it was that.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Knowing that, you know, what comes to your mind when you think that? What you know?
I mean, for me, like I have a little girl that's about to turn 7 in June, and knowing that now, like I think about that, thinking about my kid going hungry, like. My heart breaks for that. Like, knowing how I feel about that, I don't want any kid to go through that, because there's someone out there, whether it be their birth parent or an adoptive parent, that feels the same way about them. And so, that's just another one of those things where, like, anything we can do to help these kids, like, we were there at one point. We were all these little kids at one point. And thank God we weren't one of the 1 of 5 that starved from this stuff. We're very blessed to have had families that were able to provide the food that we needed.
Yeah.
And, but there are these kids that, the 1 in 5, that are suffering from this hunger, like, and it breaks my heart. It really does.
Just think, like, you have a 7-year-old, so just think, you know, for a lot of these kids, their only meals are the free or reduced breakfast and lunch at school. And when they leave school at 3 o'clock or whatever time, a lot of them don't have dinner or anything until they come back to school the next day for breakfast and lunch.
Yeah.
Whereas summer hits, that is such a horrible time. So the music industry, you know, that's every tour time from March all through summer. But while you're helping raise awareness, some of those kids are fighting for food because they don't have that school breakfast and lunch. There's nothing, you know.
No.
So they go on the fight or flight mode. So you're helping to end that.
Yeah.
So that's what you're doing. But on a lighter note, we're here for Battle of the Bands, right? The
yes.
Tour. Tell me what you think as far as how important things like this are for the local music industry, Battle of the Bands. I mean,
holy cow. I mean, just the opportunity for any band to play Northern Invasion is huge, because Northern Invasion is one of the biggest music festivals that happens in the Midwest every year. And a night like this, for 93X to put this on and allow us local bands to come in here and compete for a chance, that's a big chance for us to raise awareness for our scene here in Minneapolis, because, you know, we had one of the biggest scenes in the mid-2000s, and it kind of died down a little bit, and now it's starting to come back, you know, with bands like Via, who's performing right now, and Emergent and Cold Kingdom, and, you know, all these bands are coming up and making big moves, and just this night alone is a huge statement for the Minneapolis scene here. Like, we've got four of the best bands that are in this scene right now that are performing, and all on the same bill, and it's one big party, it's one big group of people that are all friends, and we've had a lot of fun tonight just being here. Like,
it's been fun. It has.
Yeah.
All right, so one song that's in your iPod playlist, your own playlist, that your fans would not expect to find in there?
I'll let Craig start with this one.
One song.
Soundboard artist that you have that your guys' fans would not expect to find in there.
I actually listen to an unhealthy amount of hip hop. So it's probably something by 2 Chainz or something like that, more than likely.
I actually have the first CD that I ever bought on my phone when I was 8 years old. I re-downloaded it. It was a Space Jam soundtrack. Hell yeah. I got the Busta Rhymes, the LL Cool J, the Bugs Bunny rap song, Buggin'. I got that whole CD on there. Nobody would ever expect that coming from me.
Oh, that's great.
Brooks and Dunn? Red Dirt Road.
Hell yeah.
Red Dirt Road.
Yeah.
I don't even know you.
Come on.
I grew up on a Red Dirt Road. Plus, my very first concert ever was Brooks and Dunn, ZZ Top.
Was it awesome?
Yeah.
Same show?
Yep.
Yeah.
Same show.
Yeah.
Wow.
You know, I honestly don't know. If you were to go through it, you'd probably find a little bit of everything that you wouldn't hear me, that you wouldn't expect me to listen to. I mean, especially given what we did tonight and fuck my entire. So, yeah.
Well, so you just hit Britney Spears.
He's got some Selena Gomez on there.
He's got the Titanic soundtrack on his phone. You know he does.
Oh, the whole thing. I have to listen to it every night before I go to bed. I have to listen to it every night before I go to bed.
Chipotle burrito now.
Don't tease me like that, dog.
Don't do it.
It's
my microphone. It's my microphone now.
So yours, mine. So of all of the bands you played with, you toured with, you had time to perform with, is there any particular experience that stands up that's like, that was an amazing night, or you know, there's
we'll each have
just,
it. We've all had different experiences, so I'll give everybody a chance, but mine would probably be Drowning Pool. When we got to play with Drowning Pool, I lost it because I loved that band growing up.
How was it? Because I interviewed CJ. I got to interview him.
Did you? Mm-hmm. It was great. Those guys are awesome. And, you know, I used to go to the club back in the day. I was a club kid back when the club music was still good. Anyways, at the end of every night at this place called Waterworks I used to go to, they used to play Bodies Hit the Floor. As loud as possible as we were leaving, so playing with those guys was a whole another experience for me.
You know, I've played with a couple different bands over the past few years, and I've had some really, really cool experiences playing with different bands, different venues and stuff, but honestly, like, the best one for me was with these guys when we played Turtle Lake Casino out in Wisconsin. We opened up for Hoobastank. We got to hang out with those guys, and I mean, the whole show was packed. It was a packed show for that particular night, and it was just a lot of fun. Like, those guys, it's nice to see, like, these big bands that have gone toured worldwide and make these platinum hits and everything, and sorry, we're getting distracted. We got people coming in here. Holy shit, we found this guy.
Found the missing band member.
Found the band member.
Sorry, guys. I got lost in the mist.
But no, Hoobastank is probably my favorite one because the guys are so cool, and it's nice to see, like, these touring bands that have, you know, made multi-platinum albums and toured worldwide to be so down-to-earth and so cool, like, to not get lost in the limelight and get caught up with the ego trip that comes with a lot of that stuff. So.
I would have to say mine. Like, I just moved here and started playing shows in this scene, but it would have been back, I don't know, it was probably 10 years ago, and it would have been with Vanilla Ice.
Seriously?
We all went on his tour bus, and it was funny, he passed out, and his buddies got, like, black hair dye, and they put a bullseye on top of his head on his fucking, on his blonde hair, and he woke up the next morning, he was pissed, and he had to go find, like, a fucking barbershop to, like, fix his shit. Like, so that's probably the craziest one I have.
Come on in, Eli.
Best band or famous person you met along the way?
Playing a show. Just talk into the microphone there.
What the? Is this a microphone?
Yeah, it's a microphone.
What the hell is
is this?
Don't you wonder how, you know, presidential
candidates... I feel like I should be swallowing this with some water.
10% really, like 10%.
It's a giant pill or something.
It's got to be 10%.
What was your favorite show experience with, whether it be, you know, in the state here, like national band, like for a big band that we played with?
Just go to the last question.
If the battery's about to go, so I'm going to ask the last question.
Saving Abel, because they treated us well.
Saving Abel.
All right, so the last question I ask before this dies here is I give everybody a chance to think like the Ice Bucket Challenge. You get to nominate three bands or artists to keep the project going, kind of like we called you out.
Oh, we're doing this now?
Yep, so you call three right now that like, you see this? You got to do it.
All right, I would like to call out the
AS.
So Steve Starks, Joey Steele, Eli Pete, and their other guitar player, their brand new guy. Don't know what his name is. AS does it. Cold Kingdom.
Cold Kingdom has been nominated with seven times.
They're doing it seven times, and I don't give a shit.
Let's do Via then.
And then Via's. Via's done it.
Via's already done it.
Who the fuck?
You didn't even have to
go. Dividing Eden.
Dividing Eden.
You got, all right, there you go, guys. Come on.
Dividing Eden.
All right.
And
emerging.
One more? Doing four?
You need three. I'm going to say...
I already said three.
Throw emerging on there.
Yeah, emerging.
They might not. I don't think they've been nominated, so we'll do
emerging. Let's just start throwing off bands. Right, Vaudeville, right. Emergent. Fucking anti-star.
All right, so that was our interview with Ashes from Stone, right, for the North Invasion Battle of the Bands. Thank you guys for helping us raise 1 million meals this year.
Fuck awesome. Yeah.
Woohoo!
Thank you.
Right, it's going to be about dead anyways.